Lots of people say to me, Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, I'd like to be able to carve a swell jack-o'-lantern, but I just don't seem to have the knack. Well, these are a few pointers on the fine art of creating the perfect jack-o'-lantern. Rule number one, you want to start out with a pumpkin that looks like a pumpkin. I mean, don't get one of them gnarly old jobs that looks like Carl Malden's nose on a cold day, okay? Now, this is a good-looking pumpkin. Now, the next thing you want to do is draw a face on that pumpkin that looks realistic. I mean, don't just start carving away freehand. You might want to work from an actual photograph, like maybe of a famous person like, oh, you know, Ozzy Osbourne or this dude, okay? Now, do the best you can at drawing that face on the pumpkin. Use a magic marker like this, you know. And draw a really good mouth on there, okay? And then you might want to put a nose like that. And then draw two eyes that look right, okay? There. Now, don't that look just like Rick Ocasek from the Cars? Okay, now it's time to carve those features. Now, choose your cutting instrument wisely. Lots of folks like to use the traditional butcher knife for this part, but I prefer this. A chainsaw. Voila! A thing of beauty, just like me.